I was asked to show how to take a hard drive apart to salvage the magnets out of it. It's not that hard. You do need to have the correct bits. Oftentimes these have what they call a security bit or an oddball size that you may not have in the standard set. Even if you have a screwdriver like this, if it includes Torx bits, it won't go that small. That's a T8. I've already gone around and loosened all these screws. Take them all out. You can feel around on one of these labels, feel for an indentation. Hidden underneath the label is one more of these fasteners. Needless to say, once you take these apart, you forget about your warranty. And here we have the hard drive, and the magnets we want are right here. We can unscrew this piece. And that magnet will come off of there. This drive just has one platter in it, and these are amazing mirrors. I haven't found a good use for these yet, but that's pretty well as taking that apart, and this is the motor that spins that. At this stage, if all you want is the magnets, you remove one more screw down here. Probably not a good idea to wear a good watch around these when you're doing this. Now you have the two magnets. You can take this apart the rest of the way. That's the motor. Circuit boards on the back side. Circuit board, throw that away. Throw that away. You can peel off these pieces of tape that are used to seal the different holes in the drive. This is a insulating sheet that's in here. You can peel that off. Peel off the tape on all these little holes. Just sealing tape. Peel one off here. You'll find pieces of stuff in there like that. These are like filters, so these drives can breathe a little bit. Throw that away. There's another piece here that needs to come off. Get a screwdriver and that came off. Get rid of that. Then you have a nice, relatively clean piece of aluminum you can use for casting or whatever. Pretty good chunk of metal. This little bar that was on here, I just take a pair of pliers and you just bend that. That comes off real easy. You throw that away. Then you have two magnets. On the back side of one of them, there's usually a couple of little bumps you have to grind off, and that'll sit flat. If you need, you can drill these holes out a little bit bigger for a mounting hole. If any of these pieces get in the way, you can cut them off with a hacksaw. This one You've got these little legs that stick up in the way. You can enlarge these holes. You could drill another hole here if need be. The only problem with drilling or cutting on these is the filings and chips go straight to the magnet. I don't know if these are glued together or not. I don't know if there's a piece of double-sided tape behind there. They sometimes will come loose, but they can also break. And just like that, the very strong magnets, you gotta be careful what you're doing around them. Now I've done it. They will snap together. I've been told people have had success with putting a putty knife or a blade between the metal and the magnet and prying those loose, or prying between the magnet and this plate here to get it to slide and get it to start to come off of there. I don't do that. These things, the magnets have been known to break, and they can shatter and put off little shards. And these metal plates actually make the magnet stronger. I was actually quite surprised that these were metal. I didn't think they were making. These are fairly old drives. They've come out of a manufacturing facility that's been around for quite a while. And you can see by bending that surface coating has cracked and crazed all over the place. I don't think anybody will be reading anything off of those.